And it is my pleasure to introduce our afternoon session's first speaker, Adolf Mirotin, and he'll tell us about Hausdorff operators on compact abelian groups. Please.
First of all, I want to thank the organizers and especially Alexey Nikolaevich for the opportunity to make a talk at this conference. The multidimensional Hausdorff operator has the form here. Here A of U is a family of non-singular n by n real matrices. Phi of U some given local integrable function called the kernel of the this operator, and I'll call this definition classical. Firstly, it was introduced by Rogozinsky and Grabdian about 70-80 years ago as an analog of regular Hausdorff transformations for sequences and series, and this explains the terminology. As a modern development of this theory begins with the work of Liebknecht and Moritz at the beginning of this century, where Hausdorff operators on the real Hardy space H1, this was the special case of one-dimensional operator where n equals to 1. But the space was the so-called real Hardy space over reals, and they gave sufficient conditions for boundedness of this operator. The n-dimensional classical definition is due to Brown, Moritz, and Liebknecht-Lerner about 2002, 2004, something like that. The problem of defining a Hausdorff operator on general groups was posed by Liebknecht in 2018. And the answer to this question is as follows. I'll consider the group L of G of all topological automorphisms of general topological group G. The initial data is as follows. The family AFU of topological automorphisms. First of all, the general measure space omega mu, the family AFU of topological automorphisms numbered by points of omega, and the kernel phi of u, some locally integrable function with respect to mu. Of course, the classical definition is a special case of this definition, where G, where G is Rn, and mu is a Lebesgue measure, omega is Rn as well. Since we consider general measure space omega mu, the following class of operators is called discrete Hausdorff operators is a special example of our general definition. The problem of the boundedness of the general our Hausdorff operator in Lebesgue spaces for p greater or equal to 1 is quite simple, and the following condition: the product of the kernel and the modulus of the automorphism AFU to the power minus 1 over p should be integrable with respect to mu. This condition is sufficient for the boundedness of our Hausdorff operator in the Lebesgue space LP over G group G, in the case where G is locally compact, general locally compact topological group, and LP of G means with respect to the higher measure. And this condition, is sufficient, but it cannot be weakened in general, and the proof bases only on the general Minkowski integral inequality. this is quite a simple problem. But if we ask the problem of the boundedness of our operator, this operator in Hardy spaces of BMO, this is a more interesting question. And the answer to this question for the case of locally compact, not necessarily abelian, not necessarily compact, for locally compact group G, and for homogeneous spaces of G, if we consider the Hardy H1 of G space real atomic, we investigated in my paper in 2019 under the conditions that the group G is metrizable and satisfies the doubling or local doubling property. Local doubling means that for every positive B there is a constant D B, which depends of course on B, such that for every ball in our group G of radius R, this radius is less than B, the following estimate holds, where nu is the higher measure of the group G. But such group as the infinite dimensional torus does not satisfy even the local doubling property. This was mentioned by Professor Bendikov at this conference, at the last OTA conference this year in August. And he posed a question, how to deal with this case, with the case of groups that are not satisfy the local doubling property. The a priori generality for solving this question is to consider the general compact and connected abelian groups. Of course, the infinite dimensional torus is compact and connected abelian group. And we consider the general framework of such groups. So the aim of the talk is to give conditions for boundedness of Hausdorff operators on several spaces of a compact abelian group if this group does not satisfy, in general, should not satisfy the local doubling property. It should not be metrizable, of course. I am sorry, but
maybe you have questions.
Yes.
About the double group. Let me understand. Does this double group property correspond to the double property of a measure in case of measurable space?
Of course, of course. It's a special case where the measure is a higher measure of the group. Of course, of course. To formulate our main results, I'm sorry, but I need to list several notions. And these notions are classical. A great part of these notions are classical and quite simple. And the first notion is the notion of the dual or character group. If H be any topological abelian group, the dual or character group of H, H hat, is by definition the group of all homomorphisms, continuous homomorphisms of the group H into the circle group T. And if, for the case where our initial compact connected abelian group is G, I'll define by X its dual group. But in general, for every abelian group X, if this group is total ordered, this means that there is a total order in this group, and this total order agrees with the group action, with the group operation. So the positive cone for such order is defined by, is denoted by X plus, and is defined as a set of such characters chi that greater or equal to the unit character one. Ну, here, if we use addition, one should be replaced by zero, but I consider the multiplication as a group operation in X, and so some strange definition is correct. And this set X plus the positive cone satisfies, first of all, it is a semigroup of X, and secondly, this positive cone satisfies the following two conditions. And vice versa, if we have such a subsemigroup that satisfies these conditions, one can define the total ordering in the group by the following rule. Chi is less or equals to Xi means that the Xi divided by Chi is belongs to the positive, is positive, belongs to the positive cone, simply. And the introduction of total ordering is in abelian group is very useful to use the positive cone as the initial data. It is known that a discrete abelian group X can be totally ordered if and all if X is torsion free. This means that X does not contain any non-trivial subgroup. And in turn, it is equivalent to the condition that the group G, which is the character group of X, is connected. So in the following, I assume that the, I'm sorry, that we fix some connected compact abelian group G, and in its dual group X hat, some total ordering is fixed. It is natural to consider the example of m-dimensional torus, because of this torus was the initial motivation of this work. In the case of infinite dimensional torus, characters are numbered by elements of the group Z infinity. Z infinity is the additive group of infinite sequences of integers with finite support. And the general form of the character of the infinite dimensional torus is as follows. And there are a lot of orders in every infinite abelian torsion-free group, but in the following, I fix the so-called lexicographic order with positive cone zero and n such that the first coordinate positive, otherwise the second coordinate positive, and so on. This is the positive cone for the lexicographic order. The second example, of course, is a finite dimensional torus TD. And it should be noted that there are a lot of interesting compact connected abelian topological groups, and the general construction of such groups is as follows. We choose some torsion-free discrete abelian group X, then its dual character group is compact and connected, and by the Pendragon's theorem, X is equal to G, G is equal to X, and we shall assume, as I said, that an order is fixed in X. For example, if we take the additive group of reals endowed with discrete topology SX, then G is the so-called Bohr compactum or Bohr compactification of the additive group of reals. This is quite interesting and important example. And the next example is a so-called aadic cylindroid. Here, X is the additive group of rationals with discrete topology. And then one can describe the group of characters as follows. Xa is a subgroup of the unfamiliar dimensional torus of sequences alpha n such that the following condition holds. And then the general form of the character of QD is as follows. So characters are numbered by points of the aadic cylindroid. This is a one-to-one correspondence between aadic cylindroid and the group of characters. And so the aadic cylindroid, this is a very interesting example. The aadic cylindroid is a one-dimensional, compact and connected, but not locally connected, subgroup on the unfamiliar dimensional torus, and it is the general form of this is the general form of characters of the additive group of rationals. What spaces we deal with? First of all, the Hardy space RG. This definition due to Helson and Lodes-Legger, the Hardy space, the complex Hardy space H1 over G consists of such integrable functions whose Fourier transform is concentrated on the positive core. So this space and the next space and so on depends on the total ordering. We fix some total ordering in the group G, in the group X, and then define these spaces. Complex Hardy space, if G is a circle group, we get a classical Hardy space, H1, over the unit disk. The real Hardy space, this space was introduced in my paper. The real Hardy space H sub R of G was introduced in my paper in 2017. And one of the possible definitions is as follows. This is this space consists of real parts of the functions in the complex Hardy space, and one of the equivalent norms in this space is as follows. The norm of the function f in this space is the sum of the leading norm of initial function and the leading norm of its so-called Hilbert transform. Hilbert transform over G, in the case, in our case, when G is a compact and connected, was introduced by Buchner and Helson. And in fact, they introduced the Hilbert transform space in such a general form. And one of the possible definitions is via the Fourier transform. See the signum is, as usual, on the reals, the function on X, which equals to one on the positive cone if the chi doesn't equal to unit character, minus one for the complement of the positive cone, and zero on the unit character. And f hat is, and f tilde hat, Fourier transforms of corresponding functions. Okay. Next spaces is BMO and analytic BMO. BMO on G is the set of the space of functions of the sum f plus j tilde, where f and g belongs to, is essential bounded on the group. And BMO A, analytic BMO, is, as usual, the intersection of BMO and Hardy complex Hardy space H1. The norm is given by the following formula. We consider all representations of the function phi in the form f plus g tilde and take infinite over all such representations of the sum of norms f and g. The next definition, very natural, an order automorphism. If X is an ordered group, then the automorphism tau of this group X is called an order automorphism if this automorphism preserves the order. In other words, maps the positive cone into itself. And another definition, if we have any automorphism of the abelian group H, the dual automorphism of the dual group H hat is simply the following map for every character Xi of the group H. A star of Xi is the composition of Xi and A. That's the classical definition. And now I can formulate my main results. I recall that G is any compact and connected abelian group. X is dual group. If we take as the set of automorphisms in the definition of our Hausdorff operator, the set of such automorphisms of the group G, that the dual automorphisms are ordered, preserve the order in the dual group X for almost all U in omega, then the following assertions are equivalent. First, our operator is bounded in the complex Hardy space. Second, our operator is bounded in the real Hardy space. Third, this operator is bounded in BMO over G. Fourth, this operator is bounded in analytic BMO over G. And all of these four conditions are equivalent to the fifth condition. The kernel is an integrable function. And the next estimate for the norm in all of these four spaces holds. Quite surprising that our condition 5, which is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness in these four spaces, does not depend on G. Even it does not depend in general of the family of automorphisms with such conditions that the dual automorphism is ordered, maps the positive cone in the positive cone, and all. If we have any such family and any compact group with such family, compact and connected group, then condition 5 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of our Hausdorff operator in these four spaces. It's natural to consider the example of the unfamiliar dimensional torus, the initial problem for this work. The general form of the automorphisms of the infinite dimensional torus that satisfies the condition that the dual automorphism is ordered is as follows. All these automorphisms are numbered by the points of the so-called special arithmetic infinite lower triangular group of matrices, T1 infinity Z. This group consists of matrices that are infinite, the entries are integers, these matrices are lower triangular, and the diagonal elements of these matrices equals to 1. This explains the term special. So if U is such a matrix, then A and Z is a point in the unfinite dimensional torus, then A U of Z, I'll define this Z to the power U, is the following point of the unfinite dimensional torus. Here we use as powers the cos element of this sequence, use as powers the cos row in the matrix U. UK1, UK2, and so on, UK comes in, and the last non-zero element is 1. So it is the fact that such automorphisms have ordered duals, and the general form of the operate with the nth dimensional torus of Hausdorff operator is as follows. Here mu is any measure on this group which plays role of omega. And according to the previous theorem, such a projector is bounded in H1, H real, H1, BMO, and BMOA over the nth dimensional torus, if and only if the kernel phi is integrable with respect to mu, and the next estimate for the norm holds. It should be noted that this estimate for positive phi cannot be weakened. The last question is the action of the our operator in the space C of G, of continuous functions over the group G. Of course, if group G is first countable, then our operator is bounded, acts at, and is bounded in the space C of G. This operator maps the continuous functions on G into the continuous function, if and only if phi is integrable with respect to mu. But surprisingly, in general, our operator does not act in C of G. We can choose such G that H of F for continuous F should not be continuous. This is unbelievable, but I can give a proof. The proof is based on the next observation. Consider the classical one-dimensional Hausdorff operator. This is a special case of the general and dimensional classical Hausdorff operator, n equals to 1. Here, of course, a of u is u. This operator was considered by Rogozinsky, Hardy, Garabedian, as I mentioned many years ago. And this operator does not act in the space of almost periodic functions of Bohr if the kernel phi is continuous, is integrable. Recall that this space consists of such continuous, uniformly continuous functions on R that by the definition of Bochner is such that the translations form a relatively compact subset in the space of CB of G of bounded continuous functions on R. Indeed, assume that this is a continuous function for every phi. Then we take e to the power it sf, and so we get that for every phi, its Fourier transform belongs to the space of almost periodic functions. But it is the classical theorem of Siegel, Hewitt, and Eberlein, very old, that if the Fourier transform of some integral function is almost periodic in the sense of Bohr, then the measure phi of u du should be discrete. And we take phi continuous, so we get a contradiction. And if we want to prove the statement that the Hausdorff operator does not act in the space of continuous function for some compact connected abelian group, we should take the Bohr compactification as G. In this case, X, the dual group, is the additive group of reals with discrete topology. And if T is any real function, we denote by T hat the corresponding character of the group R. And then the map, it is known that the map beta that maps every real T to the character T hat is a continuous isomorphism of R onto a subgroup of the Bohr compactum. These groups R and the range of the beta are isomorphic as algebraic groups. So if we, as usual, identify T and T hat, we can consider, and we shall consider, R as a subgroup of the Bohr compactum. And it is known that the space of almost periodic Bohr functions on reals is isometrically isomorphic to the space of all continuous functions on the Bohr compactum via the restriction map. This restriction map is the isomorphism of these two spaces. So consider the map tau u of gamma. By definition, this is a product of u and gamma. U is non-zero real, and gamma is arbitrary real. And this is an automorphism, of course, of the group Rd. And if I want to get a contradiction to our assumption that the corresponding, we consider the Hausdorff operator with the family Tu star as the family of automorphisms of the dual group. And I state that this operator does not act in the space of all continuous functions over the Bohr compactum. If we want to prove from the contrary, it's sufficient to show that the restriction of this function, if G is any function continuous on the Bohr compactum and F is restriction to R, so it's sufficient to state this equality. Because the right hand side, if the right hand side acts on the space of continuous functions, the left hand side should act on the space of almost periodic functions, a contradiction, if phi is a continuous, if phi is continuous, as was mentioned above. So for T in R, we have the following array of, in fact, definitions. By definition, the dual automorphism to Tu. 5 minutes. The dual of Tu is Ut hat. And thus, we have the following equality, which completes the proof. As I said, if we assume that this operator acts on the space of continuous functions over the Bohr compactum, then this operator should act in the space of almost periodic functions on R, and this is not the fact. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for that entertaining talk. So we have some time for questions.
We just also, Jim, I wanted to ask you always kind of founded this outdoor operators, but was there papers on compactness, possibly operators?
I don't know any paper on the for the compact case. I published 4 papers on the locally compact case, and of course, this works for the compact case.
No, but I mean, compactness of operator.
Compactness of operator?
Yeah, not bounded.
Of course. The problem is when the Hausdorff operator is compact.
Yes.
I published only one paper last year in Russian Journal of Mathematical Physics for the classical and dimensional Hausdorff operator, that this operator under some natural conditions not only not compact, but it is not Ries operator. And of course, since it is not Ries, it is cannot be represented as a sum of compact and quasi-nilpotent operator. It is not quasi-nilpotent, does not compact, and does not the sum of such two.
Yes, I understand this in general situation, there are no hopes for the operator to be compact. But maybe in some particular situation, can be.
As regards the so-called Hausdorff operators in spaces of analytic functions. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. In this situation.
Could you give examples of some group which
This is only one. This talk contains only one theorem, and this theorem holds for all compact and connected abelian groups under the conditions of this theorem.
But you need it. It was split into with the top order.
Sorry?
You needed the total order.
Total order. Total order always take place in the dual group if the initial compact abelian group is connected. And we have a lot of total orders. We fix some total order. Then we get the H1, real H1, BMO and BMOA. The definition depends on the fixed of the order we choose. And then this theorem holds.
I want just a simple example.
A simple example was given here. The unfinite dimensional torus, the Bohr compact, the Eydick solenoid, the n-dimensional torus.
Further questions?
Yes.
In the case, sorry?
P equal to 1.
P equal to 1.
So,
as I know, in this case, the Hilbert transform is unbounded.
I know, but from the 1 to another space.
For another, for LP, where P is greater than 1, of course. As regards the space L1 over G, this is unbounded in the classical case when G is a circle group.
In your case.
Yes.
If there are further questions, then let's thank the speaker again.